Kaya naman tas naka Royal Cable ako.
Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Welcome to our class. Let me just remind everybody that this session is being recorded online so that if you have your classmates who will not be able to join us for our online session, pwede po nila itong balikan sa Blackboard Collaborate and they will just click yung mga recorded sessions. Pagkatapos po noon, pwede na po nilang balikan yung ating discussion online. So para sa mga nandyan at kasama ko sa online session ngayon, hello, hello muna kayo sa mga kaklase natin dito.
Hello, hello. What's up?
Hello, boss. Magandang umaga. Magandang umaga, everyone. I know that everybody's hungry. This is already 11:30. Hey. Pwede kayong kumain habang po tayo nagle-lecture. And again, welcome to our first lesson. Again, this is SS33, The Contemporary World. I hope you are in the right class at the moment. Okay, so this is The Contemporary World. Our first session, we'll be discussing an introduction to globalization. Okay, ang atin pong pag-uusapan ngayon ay tungkol sa konsepto ng globalization. We will try to define in the first place kung ano nga ba ang ibig sabihin ng globalization and how is it actually affecting us at the moment. Again, this is SS33, The Contemporary World, and this is our introduction to globalization. Bilang kasama po sa ating learning objectives, ito po ang mga sumusunod. First one, we will formulate a personal definition of globalization. Second one, we will differentiate the competing conceptions of globalization. Number three, we will identify the underlying philosophies of the varying definitions of globalization. And lastly, we will hopefully agree working definition of globalization for the course. Before I continue, pwede po ba akong magtanong, malakas po ba ang dating ng boses ko? Malinaw po ba? Naiintindihan po ba ng lahat? If you have any questions, pakilagay po sa chat box natin or you can click yung raise your hand button po dito sa may ilalim ng slide po natin. If you can see the picture and then you have the audio and then you have the share video at doon po sa tabi doon naka-raise your hand. Pag kinlik nyo po yan, I will recognize you because that means you want to say something, you want to be recognized, or you got some questions. Wala pong problema doon, okay? We will try to be as interactive as possible sa ating klase. Sa kasalukuyan, malinaw po ba ang dating ko sa inyong mga tahanan?
Okay po, sir.
Okay, yes, very good. Magandang... Okay, hi Hannah, you raised your hand. May question tayo? Ayan, kinlik nyo po yung raise your hand, ibig sabihin you want to be recognized, ha? Okay, tuloy-tuloy na po tayo sa ating session at the moment. Magandang tanghali po, this is our introduction to globalization. Now, when we talk about globalization, ano ba yung unang-unang mga pumapasok sa isip natin? We have to identify first and understand what we mean by globalization. Now, when we talk about globalization, it is a complex phenomenon. When we say it is a complex phenomenon, this occurs at multiple levels, experienced in numerous ways by people. One thing that we have to at least zero in on this definition is the fact that globalization is a complex phenomenon. When we say that globalization is actually a complex phenomenon, this means that this is something that is not easy to understand. Right? Because if we say that globalization is complex, from the word complex itself, meaning ito po ay nagsasanga-sanga. Hindi siya isang simpleng bagay na nangyari na lamang. Kumbaga, it happened and it became so complex because at least it occurred at multiple levels and experienced in numerous ways by people. Meaning, ang mga tao po sa paligid natin, perhaps including all of us here, we experience globalization in different ways, okay? Depending on where we at, our setting, our environment, perhaps it all depends on what we are doing at the moment. And what we are doing right now is actually a product of globalization. So let's try to define what globalization is all about. Now, when we talk about globalization, informally, it is what the collapsing of borders, or what we call as the shrinking of the world. When we say that globalization is what we consider as the collapsing of borders, ano kayang ibig sabihin nito? Now, when we talk about the world in particular, this is what? Consisting of a lot of nations, right? Maraming mga bansa ang kasama dito. And all these states, okay, have their own borders. But when we talk about globalization, it actually is considered as the collapsing of borders. What do we mean by the collapsing of borders of the countries when we talk about the phenomenon of globalization? So we talk about the shrinking of the world, the collapsing of borders. So what does this mean? Ang ibig sabihin po nito, pag pinag-usapan natin ang collapsing of borders, it's very easy for us right now to know what is going on in different countries, okay, in just a click. Ibig sabihin, the world has shrunk, lumiit ang mundo, because dati, somehow, before the advent of the internet era, what we only know about our country is what we just know about our country. We don't know what's happening around the world. Pero dahil sa advent ng computers, because of the advent of internet, mas mabilis natin ngayong nalalaman kung ano ang nangyayari sa buong mundo. Okay, the reason why somehow we were able to prepare, or perhaps we were not really able to prepare that much doon sa pandemic na nangyari ng coronavirus 2019 was because we already have an idea of what is going on in the world. And that's the reason why we say that there is a shrinking of the world, because perhaps the world has become smaller by virtue of the process of globalization. Now, when we talk about globalization, this has become beneficial to a lot of people, but this is not entirely positive, meaning this is not at all to the advantage of everyone. Say, for example, we talk about mail order brides, okay? So we talk about mail order brides, and this is something that I think I have already discussed with you during our first and last online session. Naalala niyo po yung kinwento ko tungkol sa mga Koreans na, mga Pilipinong nag-aasawa ng mga Koreano. Tama po ba? Naalala niyo ba? Hello, hello? Wala pa ba ako nagkwentong gano'n? O si Jasmine, di ba may nagkwento ako sa klase ng gano'n? Wala? Ah, hindi pa. Okay. Hindi ko pa nagkwento sa inyo. Okay, let's look at this one. Now, when we talk about the concept of mail order brides, ngayon, di ba, with the advent of globalization, you consider of intermarriages of different cultures, right? Maraming mga nag-aasawa ng mga Pilipino na ibang lahi, ganun din naman mga ibang lahi na nag-aasawa ng Pilipino. That is actually a repercussion of the idea of globalization. And when we talk about mail order brides, minsan ngayon, ang mga tao nakakapamili na lamang ng kanilang mapapangasawa sa mga panahong gusto nila. And this is not only happening online, but definitely when you talk about the concept or the perspective of trying to do intermarriage between different cultures, it's very rampant, definitely for third world countries. I'm not sure, no, kasi sabi nung iba sa inyo, parang hindi ko pa naikikwento yung sa Korea about yung mga nagpapakasal. Now, I already told you that I studied in Korea for 4 years. It was an international school. We speak English, but then again, in order for me to survive the culture, I have to at least learn the language, and also I have to at least know the culture. And in my 4 years of stay in Korea, in Seoul in particular, I realized that there were a lot of Filipinos in particular who are getting married with Koreans. Okay. At yung pagpapakasal po nilang ginagawa nito, it's something that somehow very much surprised me, if I may say. Now, there was a moment when one of my friends here in the Philippines, okay, please tell me kung hindi ko pa nasasabi ito sa klase. Then when one of my friends here in the Philippines actually got married to a Korean, that was a couple of years after my sister, who is her best friend, got married. Okay, so after my sister got married, wala na kami halos naging communication nung kaibigan naming ito. And then it was only after a couple of years that we found out that she got married to a Korean. This is a true story, by the way. Now, she got married to a Korean. And then I didn't know until she found out that I was already in Korea studying. And so during that time, minessage niya ako, minessage ko rin siya, sabi ko, nasaan ka? And she was actually in Gwangju City. Gwangju City is actually like 6 hours away from Seoul. Okay, so medyo malayo kami. But then that was the moment when I found out that she got married to a Korean. And then, it was not only her that I found out who's a Filipinos who got married to a Korean, because staying there, I was able to immerse myself amongst the Filipino Koreans and even their families. So medyo nakilala ko yung sistema doon. And I found out that there are a lot of Filipinos who are getting married sa mga Koreans, but not only Filipinos, but even so, many Southeast Asian countries. Perhaps some of them were into the idea that perhaps if they could get married with Koreans, maayos ang buhay nila. Because, you know, you talk about Korea, you talk about the Hallyu, you talk about the Korean wave at the moment. And it started even before you were in high school, even when you got acquainted with all these K-pop and K-dramas and whatnot, right? So during that time, I realized na ang dami palang mga Southeast Asians na nagpapakasal sa mga Koreano, in particular mga Vietnamese, mga taga Myanmar, mga Indonesians, mga Filipino in particular. And I realized na marami sa kanila nilang ito ay kapit sa patalim. Okay? They don't even know who they're getting married with until such day that they will get married. And one of the experiences that I had was when I joined a particular Filipino community na meron kaming pupuntahan. So this was a group of Filipino people na mag-tour somewhere in Seoul. But just about where we were to leave the place, biglang may humarang na isang kotse dun sa may van na sasakyan namin. At paglabas nung tao sa may kotse, lumabas isang ajumma, isang matandang babae, and then isang lalaki doon na sumisigaw. I mean, hindi ko maintindihan yung sinasabi nila kasi masyado nang malalim at mabilis yung sinasabi nila. But I know that they were making already a scene during that time. So I was asking, ano ang nangyayari? What seems to be the trouble at that time? And so I found out that the old lady was actually the mother of a Korean guy who got married with a Filipina. Okay? At gusto niyang pababain yung Filipina na asawa ng anak niya na kasama namin. So these are things that I don't know because I just joined the Filipino community at that time. Kasi ito palang Filipinong ito ay kasal sa Koreanong lalaki. Pero ang naging problema was hindi kinaya nung babae yung ginawa niyang pagpapakasal at hindi niya natutunang mahalin yung Koreanong kanyang pinakasalan. Blunt enough to say that the guy said na wala pang nangyayari sa kanila since they got married. And so, lumayas itong Filipina sa bahay nila, nagtago. Okay, at ngayon, nung panahon na yon ay hinahanap ng kanyang asawa. You know, when you talk about stories like this of intermarriages, these are not all stories na successful. I've seen a Filipino also who was a member of the church where I was attending, na ma-attend ako nung panahon na yon. And during the first years of her married life, it was okay. But then again, ang nangyari na aksidente yung kanyang asawa bagok yung ulo niya. At pagkatapos po noon ay hindi na bumalik sa normal yung kanyang asawa. And so what happened was she was the one who's taking care of her husband at the moment. And doon naman sa aking kaibigan, her story was also a very different story because I think it was during my third year in my master's degree when she called me up one time and then she was crying. Okay, sabi niya sa akin, Erland, punta ka dito. Sabi ko, oy, why, anong problema? Sabi niya, my husband is dead. Sabi ko, oh, no, no. Okay, namatay yung kanyang asawa. Well, I somehow already known the husband because I was going to and fro Gwangju because at that time I had a part-time job in Gwangju City. So I had to go there every weekend, okay, for about 1 year. Yun yung ginagawa ko. So sabi ko, anong nangyari? Sabi niya, na hit and run daw yung kanyang asawa. Sabi ko, so what happened? Yung asawa niya pumunta ng bundok because if ever you'll be able to travel to Korea, you will realize na yung kanilang mga tombstone doon ay meron silang mga tombstones sa mga bundok. Okay, and that's something that surprised me the first time. So, itong asawa niya ay nagpunta sa may bundok para linisin yung puntod ng kanyang asawa. But then, the husband was drunk. And when he's done, pababa niya ng bundok, na hit and run yung kanyang asawa. But that was not the only trouble. Okay? The reason why she was crying was because she heard the conversation between the mother of her husband and the siblings of her husband. And during that time, itong aking kaibigan po is magaling na siyang mag-Korean. Okay? She was just waiting for her, tawag dito, yung Korean, may residency na siya. Okay? But citizenship. Okay? She was waiting for her Korean citizenship na makuha na niya. At ang sabi niya, ang pinag-usapan daw ng kanyang mga, ng kanyang biyanan at ng mga kapatid is kapag nalibing na yung kanyang asawa, kukuhanin nung kanyang biyanan yung kanyang anak. And that was a sad story. Okay, so I sabi ko sa kanya, Myla, I have an exam for this week, but let me just finish my exam and then I will go straight to your place. So I went straight to the Gwangju after the exam. And then nag-usap kami dalawa. During that time her sister was also there. So sabi ko, ano nangyari? So kukuhanin nga daw sa kanya. So ang plano niya is pagkatapos ng libing ng kanyang asawa, itatakas niya yung kanyang anak. And that's what happened. Okay? Ayun po ang nangyari. Okay? So hindi siya nagpapakita sa kanyang biyanan for a couple of months. Okay? Because of what happened. And then, so bumalik ako ng Seoul for my studies and then tumawag ulit siya sa akin. Sabi niya, Erland, I'm going to Seoul. With my daughter, tsaka yung kapatid niya. Kasi nandun sa Korea nun yung kapatid niya. Ang plano nila is kukuha niya ng Filipino passport yung kanyang anak. Aayusin niya rin yung passport niya. Because again, Korea actually is okay with having dual citizenship, just the same as the Philippines. So, nung papunta na sila, sabi ko, sige, punta kayo dito sa gantong araw para kahit papano I could join them para masamahan ko sila sa may Philippine Embassy sa may Seoul. So, nung nandun na kami, while we were having, I think, our lunch, okay, at that time, sabi niya sa akin, Erland, ganito, if worst comes to worst, ibibigay ko sa iyo ang anak ko, please pakidala siya sa Pilipinas. Sabi ko, sandali, teka, parang may problema rito. Hindi ako gusto, parang ito yung teleserye na nangyayari. Ha? Sabi ko, gano'n. Parang sandali lang, I have to observe what's going on. Sabi niya kasi, what she's trying to point out is that if first comes to worst, I have to bring her daughter to the Philippines. Kaya lang, sandali lang, para wala akong planong baka mamaya makasuhan pa ako ng human trafficking kapag ganoon. Sabi naman niya, if first comes to worst, good thing, hindi naman po nangyari yon. But then again, after a year yata, that's the only time na nagpakita siya sa kanyang biyanan at idinala niya yung kanyang anak sa kanyang biyanan para ipakita. Because definitely naminis naman ng lola yung kanyang apo. But then again, what I'm trying to point out was hinintay niya muna na siya ay maging Korean citizen para may protection na rin siya from the government bago siya dumating or bago siya magpakita ulit sa kanyang biyanan. Now, these are stories of the repercussions of globalization. It's a complex phenomenon, but it is also an even one, if I may say. It's not only for the advantages of everybody, it also has its disadvantages, its not so good ramifications, if I may say. Now, when we talk about globalization, this is defined as that process of interaction and integration among people, companies and governments of different nations, a process perhaps driven by the international trade and investment and aided by information technology. One of the things that we have to zero in on this definition is that when we talk about globalization, this is a process of what? A process of interaction. Okay? This is a process of interaction, but not only interaction, but also what? Of integration. Among who? Among people, among companies and governments of different nations, a process, okay, that was driven by international trade. So when we talk about international trade, we are talking about what? Economic globalization and investment, and aided definitely by information technology. Okay, globalization somehow came to us as a product of the internet era. Okay, at the advent of computers and whatnot. Now, as we continue, let's look first at the defining technologies of globalization. And when we talk about these defining global technologies of globalization, okay, Camille Christopher Garcia, where are you? Hi, Camille. Hi, Camille. Are you there? Ay, hindi ko marinig si Camille. Nagbabasa siya salita ka, Camille. Can't hear you. Siguro iaayusin niya muna yung kanyang audio dito. Okay. Where is Aldrin Angelo Miranda? Hi, Aldrin. Okay ba yung audio mo dyan? Yung microphone? Is it working? Hi, Aldrin. Nakapukang nawawala si Aldrin. Ah, hindi gumagana yung kanyang audio. Okay. Anyone who wants to read these defining technologies of globalization, okay, pakiclick na lang po yung raise hand dito. Okay, ayan. So, I will be able to recognize you. Okay. Sino po yung gustong basahin ito? Okay. Tingnan po natin. Ay, walang gustong sumagot. Mary Jasmine, nasaan ka?
Sir Camille po.
Hi Camille. Okay, hi Camille. Hi Camille. Pakibasa naman dito yung mga defining technologies of globalization, please.
Ito pong computerization, satellite okay. Communication, fiber optics and the internet, miniaturization, digitization.
Okay, thank you very much, Camille. So these are the defining technologies of globalization. When you talk about computerization, almost everything is already computerized at the moment. Even the files of the government, okay, nawawala na yung mga hard copies natin. Kaya kapag nag-bug down yung system, yari tayong lahat, okay? But that's part and parcel of globalization. Another one is when we talk about satellite communication. That's the reason why we are able to communicate definitely sa ating mga phones is because of satellite communication. Another one is what? Fiber optics in the internet. Definitely, this has become the starting point of globalization. Okay, yung internet era natin. And of course, you talk about digitization. When you talk about digitization, tandaan ho natin dito, everything has become so digital at the moment. Even the way we consume services. Okay, na sa dati. I remember, no, I'm not sure if you're still familiar, noong pong mga 1990s, okay, na kapag mga holidays usually, usong-uso pa noon na ang mga pamilya ay nagre-rent ng mga VHS tapes, okay, ng mga DVDs, wala pang DVDs nun masyado, tapos iuuwi nila iyon, tapos dyan na yung Video City, okay, yung unang pag-consume natin. But then again, after that, everything has become so digital. So even the movies we watch right now can be downloaded digitally. Okay, and also we have the concept of miniaturization kung saan pinapaliit or lumiliit ng lumiliit, okay, yung mga gamit natin. Okay, say for example, when you talk about, say for example, yung music na kinukonsume natin. When you talk about music, I'm not sure siguro yung iba sa inyo, sa mga bahay ninyo, you still have yung tinatawag natin na mga malaking mga CDs, okay? Para mga jukebox, sino may mga jukebox pa sa inyo sa bahay na hanggang ngayon ay ginagamit nyo pa? Or kung hindi nyo man ginagamit, parang ginawa nyo ng display sa may bahay ninyo. So that's the first time that we tried to consume music, yung napakalalaking mga vinyl, okay, na mga tawag po doon. Okay, so ngayon medyo bumabalik yung mga vinyl po na
Hello?
Hi, boss.
Hi. Okay. So, ngayon bumabalik yun. And then, after that, anong nangyari sa mga music na kinokonsume natin? Sino sa inyong nakakalala ng mga cassette tapes? Ayan. Yung mga cassette tapes natin. Di ba? Meron ko ba kayong mga cassette tapes ngayon? Maalala ko, di ba? Pag-dinig napuputol pa, tapos ikinakabit natin. Okay, then, pagkatapos ng mga cassette tapes na yon, nawala na sila at naging mga CD. Okay, yung mga music natin. Okay, CD at pagkatapos ng CD, ano na ang nangyari? Okay, sino nakakalala sa inyo yung mga MP3 players? Right? Mga MP3 players pa natin dati. Meron pa ba kayong mga MP3 players ngayon? Pagandahan pa? Okay. Naalala ko dun sa may cassette tapes, meron pa tayong tinatawag na mga Walkman. Tama? Meron pa ba kayong mga Walkman hanggang ngayon? Diba? And after that, of course, anong ginawa na natin as Spotify na ngayon? Ayan, naka-Spotify na tayo or sa iTunes na we try to download music. And in the Philippines, it's very easy to download movies and music. Okay. Dahil walang pangil ang ating batas pagdating sa ganyan. Okay, so these are some of the defining technologies of globalization. Now, these are some of the possible definition of globalization. Many view globalization primarily as an economic process. And when we say that globalization is primarily an economic process, what we're trying to point out is that the evolving structure of the global economic market, ayun yung point of reference, okay, ng globalization. So you talk about the importation and exportation of tangible and intangible goods and services. It's not just an importation and exportation, but we import and export goods and services right now at a very fast rate, okay, regardless of economic locations. And this seem to be the power of globalization. Now, economic globalization, definitely this provides what? An acceleration, liberalization, and somehow an explosion also of the global market. So, when reports say may mga nationalists na ayaw nila ng globalization, when they say that the integration of the national markets to a wider global market signified by the increased free trade, one of the ramifications of globalization is the increase of free trade. Okay? Malayang nakakapag-trade ang mga tao all around the world. See, for example, bibili ka ng mga gamit sa Alibaba. Okay? What is that? I'm sorry. Wag na nga lang doon. Sa eBay. Okay? Halimbawa, sa eBay, bibili ka. Okay? Saan pa? Ano yung ano, yung may si Jack Ma ang may-ari? Ano yung pag-aari ni Jack Ma? Ah, tama, Alibaba nga. Okay, tama ako. Ang iniisip ko kasing Alibaba ngayon yung sa may ano, what is that? Aladdin.
Aladdin.
Okay, iniisip ko mali yung sinabi kong Alibaba. Okay, di ba? Yung mga commodities natin ngayon, you can actually order abroad and very fast. Pwede mo siyang makuha. Okay, dito ka agad sa Pilipinas. So, when activists allude to anti-globalization, meaning there are people who are actually against the concept of globalization because what they are trying to defy, okay, ay yung trade deals na pinapacilitate ng WTO or ng tinatawag nating World Trade Organization. Now, globalization, scholars do not necessarily disagree with people who criticize unfair international trade deals or various global economic organization. Okay, so you talk about deals in importation, deals in exportations and whatnot. However, unlike these critics, who view globalization in strictly academic terms, iba ang pagtingin ng academics, okay, nasa educational system when we talk about the concept of globalization. In the study and analysis of globalization, ang approach ng mga academician, okay, is one that is interdisciplinary. Ang ibig nito, we look at globalization from multiple theories and different perspectives. According to Manfred Steger, this is how he defined what globalization is. For him, this is first the what? Expansion. Okay? And what? The intensification of what? Of social relations and consciousness across world time and across space. So when you talk about the concept of globalization, at least from Manfred Steger's perspective, this is an expansion of social relation, which is true, right? We are not just socializing with the people in our own vicinity, okay? But we are socializing even with people from different countries. Now, halimbawa, kayo ay naglalaro ng Mobile Legends. Sino rito yung mga batak sa Mobile Legends? Ayan, si Ichiro, nagtaas ng kamay. Okay. Kung ikaw ay batak sa paglalaro ng Mobile Legends, ang mga kalaro mo ay hindi lang naman mga Pilipino. Tama po ba ako? Salamat sa sagot. Opo. Walang sumasagot. Okay. Very good. So kapag ikaw ay naglalaro, even opo, sa mga games right now, right? Nandun ka sa may vicinity mo, nandiyan ka sa may kwarto mo, pero ang mga kalaro mo ay wala sa Pilipinas. But you are able to interact. You are able to expand social relations with other people even, okay, in the convenience of your own home, of your own house. So you talk about globalization as the expansion, and not only expansion but also the intensification of what? Of social relations and consciousness. Because when you become related socially with other people, then that's the moment that you become conscious that there is a world out there and there are a lot of people in the world out there. Now, when we talk about the concept of expansion, this refers to what? Both the creation of new social networks, right? So when you talk about the creation of new social networks, di ba? Yung generation ninyo, kayo ay napakadaming access sa mga social media accounts ninyo. Wala ano, hindi lang Facebook ang meron kayo. Ano pa ang meron kayo? Meron kayong Instagram.
TikTok.
Okay, oh, meron kayong Instagram, may Facebook, may TikTok, ano pa? Twitter. Tama, Camille. Meron pa kayong Twitter. Ano pa?
Reddit.
Ano ba mga social media accounts niya? Ano po yun?
Reddit.
Sir, Tumblr.
Okay.
Reddit.
Tumblr. Okay.
Reddit.
Ano pa? Reddit. What is Steam? Sorry, hindi ko alam yung Steam. Okay.
Sir, ano yun? Parang mga games yun, sir.
Game store. Primarily.
A game store yung Steam. Ah, okay. Apo, so, fortune. Ah, di ba, ang dami kong hindi alam na alam ninyo. Okay? Yan ang generation niya. Wala nang Friendster, Carl James. Okay. Nung panahon ko, yun ang usong-uso, Friendster. Tanungin yung mga parents ninyo. Okay. Usong-uso yung mga Friendster yung mga panahon siguro namin. And then you have MySpace. Okay. Para sa mga iba naman na naghahanap ng kanilang mga, perhaps na naghahanap ng kanilang mga, anong tawag dito? Mahal sa buhay, mamahalin sa buhay, gumagawa sila ng mga account sa Tinder. Okay? Ayan, tama, Ichiro, Tinder, di ba? I remember I tried, meron akong account sa Tinder. I just wanted to check what's going on. So pag nakita niyo po ako doon, ilang taon na po yun na hindi gumagana. Okay, you also have Snapchat, you have Bumble, you have Hi5. These are social media networks that I don't even know. Now, this is the reason why we call globalization as an expansion. Right? Well, I'm not even sure, no? Minsan nagtataka ako how you are able to actually maintain, okay, yung mga social media accounts ninyo. Whereas ako kasi okay na ako sa FB at Instagram. And that's it. I don't have Twitter accounts or whatsoever. Wala na akong ibang account. Yeah, liban doon. But then again, I can't blame you because perhaps ang galing-galing ninyong mag-budget ng time and how much time you gave for each social media account that you have. So much to say that when we talk about globalization as an expansion, this creates new social networks and also it multiplies existing connections that cut across traditional political, economic, cultural, and geographic boundaries. Perhaps, meron kayong mga naging kaibigang mga foreigners doon sa mga social networks ninyo, sa mga social media accounts ninyo, mga naging friend niyo sa Mobile Legend, okay? Mga naging friend ninyo sa Instagram, naging friend ninyo sa may Twitter, or naging friend ninyo sa may Facebook, na hindi nyo naman pareho ng kulay, hindi nyo pareho ng salita, hindi nyo pareho ng kultura. But then again, because of the expansion, okay, That was one of the reasons why what globalization is all about. We were able to create and multiply our existing connections at the moment. Another word which is very important for us to single out here is the concept of intensification, meaning we try to expand, we stretch, and accelerate these networks. Now, not only are global connections multiplying, but also they become what? More expansive. But even though it has become so expansive, the more the world is becoming so small because of the concept of globalization. Again, when we talk about globalization, it's a borderless world, okay? So just like a world in miniature. Now, let's look at the repercussions or the ramifications of globalization with a case in point of what happened with Honda. Okay. Now, in 2012, nagkaroon ng monsoon rain na tumama sa may Bangkok, sa may Thailand. As you may well know, ang Honda plant in Bangkok actually is producing crucial car parts that are then subsequently imported by Honda USA. Dahil sa nangyaring monsoon rain sa may Bangkok, the Honda plant in Thailand failed to produce car parts within schedule. Pero hindi naman po yung Honda sa may Bangkok ang naapektuhan nito. Since they were not able to produce yung mga materials na kailangan nila, Honda USA was unable to reach its sales target. And with that, the ability of service centers all around the US to assist Honda owners also suffered. Ultimately, the Japanese car company's overall global profit dipped. And it is only because of the monsoons that took place in Bangkok. So you see how
imagine
the world is affected, okay, ng isang pangyayari sa isang bansa. Kasi the commodities that we have right now, okay, especially sa mga sales, di ba? Alam na siguro ng iba sa atin yon, especially sa mga sales, okay? Hindi lang yan ang gagaling sa isang bansa. Some of the parts ay ginagawa sa Thailand perhaps, yung iba ginagawa sa may Africa, tapos pagsasama-samahin nila ito, deliver sa ibang bansa, okay, para ito ay magamit. So, this is what globalization actually brought to the world at the moment. And perhaps that's one of the things that we have to consider at least. Now, the final attribute doon sa statement ni Manfred Seger when you talk about the concept or the definition of globalization is that it's actually very much related to the way we perceive space and time. Steger, according to him, globalization processes do not occur merely at an objective material level, but it also involves the subjective plane of human consciousness. In other words, the feeling that the world is at our fingertips. You wake up in the morning and then you hold your phones and then you check your Facebook news feed. Alam mo na kung ano ang nangyayari sa Japan. Alam mo na kung ano ang nangyayari sa China. Or perhaps, let's try to contextualize it at the moment. When you check your news feed right now, nakikita mo kaagad kumusta ang coronavirus pandemic sa Italy, which is the worst case of the coronavirus disease at the moment. Diba? Because Europe has become the center of coronavirus. Diba? Nag-exceed na sila sa may death toll kesa sa China. And also not only in Italy, makikita mo rin doon kumusta ang coronavirus pandemic sa may Spain, which also has exceeded the number of deaths in comparison to China. Okay, that's why Europe become the epicenter of the coronavirus disease. What we're trying to point out is that when we look at the news online, it gives us a feeling that we already know what is happening with the world out there. It's like the world is already at our fingertips. And that's what globalization is all about. Now you can message virtually anyone and get a reply almost instantaneously. That's the reason why even while I am having our discussion right now, pwede kayong mag-chat dito ng inyong mga tanong. You can raise your hand so we can discuss. So you see, kung wala tayo sa panahon ng globalization and the coronavirus pandemic actually took place, wala tayong online session sa kasalukuyan. There is no and there will be no other way. Diba? So, at least we can be thankful for the concept or the process of globalization. Kasi kahit papano, nakakatulong sa atin sa kasalukuyan. Sana. Okay? Now, you are exposed to news outside your national borders, thus gifting you with a more profound sense of what is happening in far-off places. That's one of the things that I've already discussed with you a while ago, that just at your fingertips, you will be able to understand and know what is actually transpiring across the world, okay? Despite of the borders and all that. Now, let's talk about the concept of globalization and globalism. According to Steger, globalization should not be mistaken for an ideology called globalism. These are two different concepts. Now, when we talk about globalization, this is all about the many processes that allow for the expansion and intensification of global connections. However, when we talk about the concept of globalism, ano ang ibig sabihin ng globalism? Okay, Darren Lopez, andyan ka, Darren. Hi, Darren. Ayan, nakatulog na yata si Darren. Hi, Darren, are you there? Darren Lopez. Mukhang hindi niya ako naririnig. Okay, Hannah Andrea Librada. Hi, Hannah. Hi, Hannah. Ayan, nawawala na sila. Hi, Hannah. Hello. Ayan, kita ako naririnig. Mukhang natulugan na nila ako. Hannah Andrea Librada, are you there?
Baka wala silang mic o baga lang internet po.
If wala kayong mic, please kindly paki-chat ako ha kung hindi gumagana yung microphone niyo. Okay, para hindi ko kayo matawag dito. Okay, so yung mga may microphone. Sinong gustong magbasa ng definition ng globalism here? Anybody whose microphones are working? Lorenzo, are you there?
Opo.
Go ahead.
Opo, sir.
Lorenzo, please read.
Ang globalism is a belief among powerful or privileged people that the global integration of economic markets is beneficial for everyone because it spreads freedom and democracy across the world.
Okay, so this is a different concept. So please do not be confused with the concepts of globalization and globalism. When we talk about the concept of globalization, he talks about the process of expansion and intensification of connections, of global connections. But when we talk about the concept of globalism, this is a what? A belief, okay? That the powerful and the privileged of the powerful and the privileged people, that global integration of economic market is beneficial para sa lahat, okay? Because it actually spreads what? The idea of freedom and democracy across the world. Jo, may pagka social consciousness yung pinag-uusapan natin dito. So that in some ways, globalism is an idealized, not to mention subjective view of globalization. But you have to understand that not everybody agrees with globalism. There are those who are actually very much adamant with the idea that globalization is not actually for the good of a lot of people. Note that when people criticize globalization, it is possible that they are merely criticizing the manifestations of globalism. Because again, globalization as a process refers to a phenomenon almost impossible to be reduced to a mere market talk. When we talk about to a mere market talk, meaning we're not only talking about globalization from an economic perspective. It's not all about economic globalization. Because when you talk about globalization, again, the cultures of people are being affected just the same. Our perspective, our worldview, the way we view things, our influences, our mindset is actually being affected by globalization. The influences that you have is being affected by globalization. And that's why when other people are talking about what is right and what is wrong, there seems to be a sort of discrepancy of what we think is what is right and wrong. One time, as I was talking with a father of a student of MCL, and he was telling me, like, sabi niya sa akin, ibang iba na yung anak ko. Because dati, kapag sinasabi namin sa kanya na ito yung tama, nakikinig siya. Pero ngayon, kapag sinasabi namin sa kanya na ito ang tama, ang sasabihin niya sa amin, hindi naman ganun yun. And I think some of you can actually relate to that, right? There are things that your parents are saying na tinatanggap ninyo, but that does not mean that you actually agree with them, right? And this is the reason why there seems to be a disconnect between you and your parents at the moment, because the kind of influence, perhaps because of the context of globalization, yung epekto ng globalization, not in an economic sense, but in the cultural sense of it, in the effects, okay, of globalization, we have to be very much careful as to how it is affecting us in our conception of what is right and what is wrong. Now, instead, for those who study globalization, they discuss the concept of multiple globalizations instead of just one. Now, according to anthropologist Arjun Aparudai, different kinds of globalization occur on multiple and intersecting dimensions of integration. Now, he called this as the scapes of globalization. Okay, so we have five scapes of globalization here. The first one is what we call as ethnoscape. Danielle, Labiabres, are you there? Danielle, yes, hello. Sir. Hi, Danielle. Kindly read the definition of an ethnoscape, please.
Ethnoscape refers to the global movement of people.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, when you talk about the global movement of people, kasama na rito yung immigration and emigration of people. Well, for students like you, perhaps yung iba sa inyo baka gusto nyo mag-aral sa ibang bansa. That's also considered as the global movement of people. Right? And when you talk about the global movement of people, we can also discuss COVID-19 with that. Now, it all started in Wuhan, in Hubei province in China. But then again, because of the global movement of people, napunta siya dito sa Pilipinas, napunta sa Amerika, napunta sa Europa, napunta sa Africa. These are some of the disadvantages of globalization. The global movement of people, okay, nasasama nila yung mga sakit, okay, nadala-dala nila doon sa kanilang mga lugar. So you talk about ethnoscape referring to the global movement of people. The second one is what we call as mediascape. Pakibasa po yung definition natin dito ng mediascape. Joshua Hernandez. Hi, Joshua. Joshua, dyan ka ba, Joshua? Hello, hello. Ayan, mukhang tulog na si Joshua. Nakatulog sa boses ko. Okay. Hi, Joshua. Okay, your mic is not working. It's okay. Okay. Hi, Kimberly. Are you there? Hi, Kimberly. Hi, Kimberly. Ayaw gumana ng microphone mo? Okay, sige. Sino gumana ng microphone dyan? Okay. Hi, Mary Jasmine. Please read the definition of mediascape here.
Mediascape refers to the flow of culture.
Okay, very good. Now, when you talk about mediascape and you talk about the flow of culture, this is something that you all are very much influenced with. Okay? So, hindi ko po alam sa inyo kung sino na ang kinain ng sistema ng K-pop. Okay, ng Hallyu, ng tinatawag natin. You talk about the flow of culture, yung kinauhumalingan ng mga Pilipino habang nakababad sila sa kanilang mga pagkaka-quarantine. Kaya ayan ang dahilan kung bakit napapagod na ang Netflix at baka daw anong mangyari. Okay? Ano ang mangyari? Okay, baka mag-break yung internet system sa Pilipinas dahil lahat ay nagne-Netflix ngayon at nanonood ng Itaewon Class ng Dam. Okay. Ano pa yung mga pinapanood niyo? Money Heist. Okay, Lucifer. Okay, mga pinapanood ninyo ngayon. Ako ang pinapanood ko kasi natapos ko na yung 2 seasons ng Kingdom. Itaewon Class naman pinapanood ko. Okay, hindi pa ako natatapos doon. But kidding aside, people, when you talk about the flow of culture, what you have to understand is that when you try to relate the culture of other people to the culture of the Filipinos, you will have trouble. Okay, because again, Korea is a very Confucianistic country and their cultures are very much dependent on the teachings of Confucius. Okay, that's their culture. And even though that's an Asian country, their culture is very different from ours. The way we view reality is somehow different from the way they view reality. Trust me, okay? At least I know how it looks like doon sa itsura ng kung paano nila tinitingnan. But that is not to say that these people are wrong. Okay, there is no concept of wrong and right when you talk about, even when we are discussing the concept of cultural relativism anyway. Now let's talk about the concept of technoscape. What is the meaning of this one? Venge Sadulio. Venge, are you there? Gumagana microphone natin, Venge. Hi, Venge.
Hindi gumagana naman.
Hi, Venge. Andiyan ka? Wala. Okay, mukhang...
Hindi gumagana okay. Naman ang ulay microphone.
Sige, si Ichiro na lang. Ichiro, please pakibasa yung technoscape.
Refers to the circulation of mechanical goods and software.
Ayan, refers to the circulation of mechanical goods and software. Ito siguro yung pwede nating ipasok dito yung ano, tinatawag natin na sample kanina ng Honda. Diba? Yung example ng Honda kanina, the circulation of mechanical goods and software. So may ibang parts na ginagawa sa may Thailand and then kailangan nila itong idala sa may Amerika. Pero dahil hindi nagawa, naapektuhan ang sales sa Amerika at yung doong mga owners sa may Japan, eh lalong nag-dip yung kanilang income dahil dito. The next one is what we call as financescape. Okay? Financescape. Tingnan po natin yung ibig sabihin ng financescape dito. Okay? Myrene Labrador? Are you there, Myrene? Hi, Myrene.
Okay.
Hi, Myrene. Pakibasa naman yung definition ng financescape dito.
Financescape denotes the global circulation of money.
Okay, pag-usapan natin ang pera. Sino maraming pera sa inyo? Ayan. Diba? You talk about the global circulation of money. Okay, so yan po mapasok yung mga remittance na tinatawag natin. And perhaps, yan, dahil wala kayong pasok, sabi nga ni Clara Gail, walang pera. Okay? Dahil walang baon. Okay? Okay. Naiintindihan ko kayo. Okay. Si Hannah daw, maraming pera. Kaka-TikTok, sabi ni Mary Jasmine. Okay. Okay. Tuloy po tayo pag-usapan natin ng
pera.
You talk about yung global circulation of money. When you talk about the global circulation of money, perhaps meron kayong mga kamag-anak or perhaps yung mga magulang ninyo. Kung hindi man yung mga kapatid ninyo or may mga kamag-anak kayo, kung may mga nagpapadala sa inyo ng pera, okay, from abroad. Meron ba rito yung mga peris ninyo yung nagtatrabaho sa ibang bansa? Sino po rito ang mga magulang ninyo yung nagtatrabaho sa ibang bansa? Ayun, si Ichiro. Ichiro, sa nagtatrabaho sila, mami at daddy?
Hi, si daddy po sa Japan.
Si daddy saan? Ichiro?
Japan po.
Sa Japan si daddy. Si mami?
Dito lang po.
Ichiro, may question ako. Kumusta si daddy sa Japan?
Ayos lang po.
Okay naman sila doon, hindi masyadong apektado yung pandemic or naka-lockdown din sila?
Ma'am, hindi ba masyadong apektado doon kayla daddy? Apektado.
Saang prefecture sila sa Japan?
San daw? Prefecture. Aichi.
Aichi daw po. Okay. Yeah, ako, nakikinig yata si mami sa lecture natin. Hi, mami. Okay. 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 Ichiro, when you talk about yung ano no, yung global circulation of money, what we have to understand here is that si daddy nagtatrabaho sa ibang bansa pero nagpapadala siya ng pera dito sa atin. So that's the process already of circulation of money. Right? You talk about yung mga remittances na natatanggap natin, yung online transfer of money, and even yung physical money. Say, for example, you go abroad, okay, and then you bring your money to that country, and then you exchange that money to dollars, and then you exchange the dollars to the money of the country na pupuntahan mo. So you talk about the global circulation already of money, and that's a product of globalization. The last one is what we call as ideoscape. Pakibasa po natin yung ibig sabihin ng ideoscape dito. Anybody, raise your hand naman. Baka may gustong magbasa nito. Last na to. Hi, Camille. Okay. Hi, Camille. Please, pakibasa po.
Realm where political ideas move around.
Okay. So you talk about political ideas move around. Okay. Now, one of the repercussions of globalization is actually in the political process of of nations. Okay, so when you talk about the concept of globalization, what you have to understand, people, is it's not just an economic process. It's not just even a cultural process. When we talk about globalization, this is also a political process. The truth is, discourses on or our talk on economic perceptions on globalization is very difficult if we are not going to analyze the political processes and institutions. Now, you have to understand that politics somehow seems to swallow the effect of global economics. Okay? Wala silang magawa eh, because of the economic globalization. Okay? Ang mga nation states or the countries have to adjust to the effect of this economic process doon sa kanilang mga bansa. Okay? You have to understand na ang mga country, sila yung nag-a-adjust sa epekto ng globalization sa kultura natin. Okay? Sila rin yung nag-a-adjust sa epekto ng globalization sa ating finances and all of it, sa ating ekonomiya. So, they have to adjust their rules on importation and exportation. They have to set boundaries on financescape, on technoscape, okay, on ethnoscape, and on mediascape. Okay, when we talk about this, what I'm trying to point out is that yung mga nation ang nag-a-adjust sa global movement of people. That's the reason why, at least say for example ngayon, mayroong mga countries na ano, hindi sila nag-a-allow na magpapasok muna ng mga foreigners sa kanilang mga bansa. Okay, yung mga foreigners, because by virtue of globalization, talagang iikot at iikot yung mga tao, particularly if they have the means anyway. But then again, these countries, okay, and these nations, okay, na may mga political leaders, they have to adjust to what the people are doing and they have to make rules, okay, and laws that they have to implement para kahit papano, the system would be in place at patuloy na maging maayos yung kanilang gagawin sa at magkaroon ng maayos na sistema sa lipunan. So again, when you talk about the intersecting dimensions of integration or discapes, again, we have ethnoscape, we have mediascape, we have technoscape, we have financescape, and ideoscape. Any questions so far, guys? Questions po? Hello, hello?
Wala naman
po. Question po tayo, Wala naman po. Okay, tuloy po tayo. Thank you very much. Now, it is more practical to view globalization through multiple lenses. Okay? Ibig sabihin nun, when we talk about understanding globalization through multiple lenses, ano ang babalikan natin dito? Babalikan natin yung konsepto ng ethnoscape, ng mediascape, ng technoscape, financescape, and ideoscape. Maliwanag po ba yung konsepto ng ethnoscape, mediascape, technoscape, financescape, and ideoscape dito sa konsepto ng globalization? I hope it's clear, because if not, please kindly tell me para ma-expound pa po natin. Okay, I think sabi nyo, yes sir, so I think we're good. Okay, let's continue. Now, the question here is, what is globalization? Okay, and perhaps we already have a very short definition of globalization, which is what? The integration and the intensification, okay, of social processes and whatnot. Okay, ang tanong din natin dito, ano yung nag-globalize natin dito? It's not only our system but even our culture, okay, the way we view things and the way we make policies as a government. Okay, so ito po yung ating naging discussion for today. This is all about an introduction to globalization. Any questions so far, guys? May questions pa po tayo? Tanong naman kayo.
Naman po. Wala.
Ayaw nyo mag-
Wala po, sir.
Sigurado kayo? Ako na lang tatanong, pwede ba yan? Parang ayaw niya. Okay, so this has been our first lecture for today. This is an introduction to globalization. Ayan, si Joshua, merong valid question dito. Sabi niya, sir, may attendance po ba ito? I will not be very strict on your attendance people because we have to consider yun pong sitwasyon ng ating mga classmates na walang internet connection. That's the reason why we are currently recording our session for their consumption. Okay, so pagkatapos po ng klase natin, after a couple of minutes, makikita nyo po sa my board collaborate na mababalikan nyo po ito doon. Okay, makikita nyo po doon yung ating discussion. So pwede nyo pong pakinggan ulit yung naging takbo ng ng session natin ngayon. Okay, si Carl James, my question, sir, medyo di kasi, meron po bang nabanggit na assignment habang wala ako? Carl, wala pa naman. Okay, I will not be giving you homeworks yet. Perhaps on Saturday, baka may quiz tayo. But you don't have to worry. If in case magpabigay ako ng unang quiz muna, I will make it easy for you guys first because I know that many of you, most of you are still adjusting. Okay, doon sa current system. How long is this going to take? Yung online courses natin, that I can't answer. We still have to assess how things are gonna go during this ECQ period, yung ating enhanced community quarantine. And perhaps after this, let's see what's gonna happen. Okay? I'm pretty sure that some of you are struggling now with the online session, particularly pag mabagal yung internet connection ninyo. Diba, o katulad yan, hindi kayo makapag-participate ng audio dahil hindi gumagana yung microphones. Pero don't worry because may chat room naman tayo rito. So if you have questions, pwede nyong i-type dito. Kaya lang para naman makapagsalita din naman kayo. At para hindi lang ako nagsasalita, kaya medyo nagtatawag din ako. Okay? Kahit papano. Hi Ryan, I understand that you are suffering because of the internet. Okay, I understand. Don't worry kasi this is recorded. Okay, the video is being recorded so you can go back to our session para po hindi ka malito at mababalikan mo yung ating discussion for today para wala pong mahuhuli sa klase natin. I will not be giving you difficult quizzes at the moment because I mean these are special times and we have to understand each other. Yes, Mary Jasmine, you have a question? Mary Jasmine, may tanong? Ah, si Sophie, anong tanong natin?
Sir, si Sophie daw po, sir, ano, putol-putol daw po yung audio. Kaya po, apo, lumabas siya kanina, tinadaw po siya makabalik.
Okay lang, kamo. Pakisabi na lang, pwede naman nating balikan. Okay, meron naman tayong FB group, I will be posting there also. Let's send ko yung link ninyo doon sa may session natin for today. Okay. Do we still have questions so far sa klase natin? Okay. Ay, please don't panic ha. Wala pong magpapanic dun sa attendance po natin. Ichiro has a question. Lahat po ba ng subject ganun din po sa attendance? I'm not sure. What I am sure of though is that we were instructed to be lenient with the attendance at this time. Okay. So I somehow interpreted that to be I should not be very strict on the attendance of you guys right now, but I am very much appreciative of the fact na you're able to join me. We are 40 in our class, if I may say, pero 30 tayo ngayon. Ibig sabihin, almost 70% ng klase natin ay nandito ngayon. Okay, so that's one good thing. Okay. Thank you very much. This has been our class, Introduction to Globalization. I will be seeing you next time around for our next session. Okay, so that is very important. Okay, I'll see you next.